Anyways, somehow got some company, and that was nice. I'm gonna tell you this, like, I didn't know that woman, and I didn't know her at all, but, you know, it felt good, you know, just to have somebody to walk with for a little bit, to talk with for a little bit, but I need to be careful about that, because, but I feel the people that seem to be the most in need of destitute, those are the ones that are the nicest, because they understand, you know, but, I mean, it felt good. It felt almost like when I was a teenager, walking with one of the girls through the hood, you know, and I miss that, you know. But of course, people try to get information from me. You know, she wanted to know where I stayed at, and I just told her different places, you know. But she was very loving and supportive. And again, you know, I have to be careful. I'm so naive. But I mean, and then she said, told somebody that I was her friend, walking, we were exercising, but that's not really what was happening. I'm walking on a 20-mile walk to an interview. She just happened to come behind me, and I turned around because I was about to vlog that she was making me uncomfortable because she was trying to catch up with me, it felt like, and I was like, you know, it just feels like that was sometimes, but it's not, but I obviously she was just walking, and she decided since we were going the same way, we'll walk together. So, okay, fine, no problem. And she talked about the thrift shop, and I didn't want to say anything. And they do have decent stuff in there, and it is decent prices. And the guy was, you know, trying to advertise his business or whatever, but he was also being fresh. I didn't like that. Being very fresh, and like, to me, it felt like if I've had people, like legitimate people, you know, legitimately, you know, seem to legitimately try to help me, you know. But then this person was like something that you would see on one of those cold case files, mysteries, because, you know, he kept going at it and I wouldn't say anything. Then he went from straight out flirting, and I was like, okay, trying to play it off like, okay, you're a good salesperson, you're just trying to make me buy stuff, you know, and I was laughing. And then he would say stuff that was really out of the way, and then I would be like, and then, you know, I wouldn't say too much, I just laugh, because I couldn't say anything. Then he was like, yeah, the thing about that is that you don't ever know if I'm joking or not, because I kept laughing like it was a joke, you know, and he was trying to put in my mind that, you know, hey, I may not be joking, you know. And then, but I think he had the vibe that my laughter was, you better be joking, because, you know, I'm not with it. Then he went from that to, you know, saying, oh, you know, because I guess he thought maybe, I've seen ads like this, like for roommates and stuff, talking about runaway hoes or something like that, and I'm not. First of all, I'm not a hoe, never have been a hoe, though I've been called that by different people that I don't know. But yeah, so, and I'm looking real tacky, and this is the time that everybody's heading to work. But the thing about it is none of those people care about me, as we saw in my past videos. So it doesn't matter. I'm getting to where I have to get to the best way I can. And if I look like I just picked up a bunch of random clothes off the street that I found on the ground, that's fine. Which actually is almost true, but they weren't on the street. Somebody advertised for free clothes, and I got them out of a big box. But anyhow, when I say big, I mean more than my height. So, but this person, like I said, straight out, the vibe is straight out of like Cold Case Files or something. Because then he's like, man, this is what concrete looks like, I guess, when it's broken. Is this concrete? Yeah, this is like, it's nothing in there but like foam, like the styrofoam stuff. So, Salvation Army. But what was I saying? So yeah, so that's the vibe he gets, Cold Case Files. Cause then he was like, I guess the vibe that I got from him was like, he was feeling like I'm some kind of, cause he was like, yeah, you showed up out of nowhere, blah, blah, blah. Like I was some type of runaway hoe or prostitute or something. I don't know what he felt I was, but he kept saying things to me, you know, like, then he would say, oh, you know, he needed some help. And I was just like, the shop is teeny. And, you know, I should have said something to that lady, because I think people need to know when we are in situations where men that are quote unquote viable men, or somebody that's doing better than us, because I wouldn't say he's viable, he's probably living in the thrift shop, but viable people, it's like, I don't know. I mean, it's instead of, I guess, because we're trying to focus, it's a catch-22. I guess we can't save the world, I guess, but because we're trying to focus on our goals and doing what we have to do to make it, we don't necessarily share you know, those experiences, because again, you don't know how other people may take it. People gossip, you know, even though you're just sharing your experience. And you know, you really don't have time for all of that. So I guess, you know, it's best, like I said, just to focus on your goal. People, again, like I said, experience in the past, they use information to not necessarily help you. So you have to be mindful. Hey, you have to be mindful and careful of that. The bus that I would be catching if I had bus fare. Well, actually, I wouldn't be catching a bus in this direction. But the bus that I would be catching is coming up behind me. And I feel bad because I ride this bus so much that the drivers probably recognize me. And I'm really dressed tacky, y'all. So bad. But, So, yeah, I feel bad because if the bus driver recognizes me and, like, tries to stop, yeah, I'm glad he didn't. But he's kind of, like, looking out for me. And he sees that I'm not running. But I feel bad because in those situations, you know, it's kind of sad. But whatever. A little embarrassing. But, yeah, so, but it's good that at least they looked out for me. I saw him look up to see if I was okay. But, but yeah, so with those, yeah, going about your business. But like I was saying, then he was like trying to say that he needed help. And I'm just thinking to myself, he has four daughters. You know, I didn't know they were daughters at first. It was four girls, like, you know, that were helping him out. But then I found out he's the daughters. And then, I don't know, he's trying to portray himself as a single dad. And then I mentioned something, you know, because they had like a room off to the side and there was a bed in there and they were, you know, eating and stuff like that. And he kept suggesting that I come back after hours, I could shop all I want. And I'm just like, no, I'm good, you know. And then he was trying to offer me, do you need work? You know, like you can help out here. And he kept saying it so much. And then after a while, I got tired of it because I was like, you have four girls here helping you already. What do you need help with? You know, and I was like, I'm not qualified. You know, and I was thinking to myself, there's no air conditioning, whatever. And then after a while, I was thinking, you know, and then he said he really needs help because the girls go back to school or whatever. And then I was thinking to myself, well, if he really needs help, and he said it was sincerity, he was trying to see which buttons to push.